Hey everybody, welcome. So happy to have each and every one of you guys here. It has been an interesting past like 20 minutes, half an hour. Sorry we're a couple minutes late, but we got it worked out. And not only did we get it worked out, but hopefully, fingers crossed, there should be no technical difficulties this time. We actually kind of got everything figured out beforehand, thank goodness. Today, by the way, I am drinking a Kyoshu Sencha Chi in my Jack Skellington mug, one of my favorite mugs here. Even more importantly today, I am streaming with an old friend of mine. He and I were interns at a church at the same time. I want to introduce you guys, Jonathan Cook. Everybody say hi to... There's Jonathan. Oh, wait, hold on. Wait. Full screen. There. Now you can say hi to Jonathan, everybody.
Hello, everyone. Welcome.
Johnny and I, so game. They can't see the game yet. Don't go yet. They can't see the game.
I'm not going.
Don't go. Where are you going? Dude, we were just trying to figure out how to connect, and we're playing a game called Unravel 2, and it's a beautiful and wonderful game, and I love it. And if you've never seen Unravel 2, you should absolutely play it. Same with Unravel as well, but we'll talk about that more later. But it was like this, I had to send him an invite to join a party. Once we joined the party, then I could change the party mode to play together. but for whatever reason, it still wasn't working. So then I had to get it. So I let him play, and then he played, and then I took it back from him to play together again, and now it's working. We got. So meanwhile,
you figured it out.
Yeah. Meanwhile, my OBS didn't want to stream because my Elgato capture was going. I had to close Elgato, stream with OBS, and then reopen it. It was all overly complicated and obnoxious, but we got it here. Anyway, Johnny, introduce yourself. Tell us about yourself a bit. Tell us about your church, and say hi.
All right. My name is Jonathan Cook, and I am the family pastor at Broadway Christian Church in Mesa, Arizona. My wife and I, her name is Heather. We moved here in 2010 from the Midwest. We both grew up in the same town in Missouri, and moved out here 2010. Steve and I interned in Arizona in 2007, and that's how we got connected. Made some epic videos that someday you should try to check out.
I tried to find them. I couldn't find them anywhere. Literally, I was going to surprise you and be like, "Dude, Johnny, look what I found!" And I was going to play some of the videos, but I couldn't find any of them anywhere. I found the Chandler Scream page, and I found a couple of my old videos, but that's it. Like I didn't find and not even all of my old videos or whatever else. So I was a little disappointed.
I have them on my personal. It's JohnnyBoy0211 is my YouTube channel. Right now, like I have a few of them hidden. I think like the water balloon ones I hid a while ago. But like the Jonathan is on there.
That's the one, man. That's the one.
What, the lamp? Remember the lamp video that we did?
Oh, yes. Oh my gosh, yes.
There was one where I just put a camera in the back seat because you had to like go pick up a vehicle or something. You had to go pick someone up from dropping their vehicle off at the shop.
JohnnyBoy0211, you said? JonnyBoy0211?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. I'm not finding it on YouTube.
That's interesting.
Send me, if you can find it, send the link. And I will play that video real quick. Guys, you need to see this video. It's wonderful. Raintree, what's up, man? Hey, Raintree, I want you to see a video that Johnny and I made like almost 20 or 15 years ago now.
It was a while ago.
15 years ago, Johnny. We old, kid.
Dude. Very old. It's ridiculous.
Are you finding it?
I'm finding it.
Yes. Oh, I'm so excited. I'm so excited, y'all. This video is legendary. Jonathan, that one. And you guys get to see my old hair. Y'all, I had a mop. It was like, boom. So
absolutely fantastic.
Lombard, Raintree, what are you doing on a Lombard, kid? Is that where you work? Anyway, Jonathan and I were interns at a place called Chandler Christian Church, and now called Compass Christian Church. And we were interns in the youth, for the youth, and part of what we do, what we did was just make like weekly videos. We had transition videos where it would just be like, you guys get to see behind the scenes here for a sec. Oh my gosh, it's beautiful.
The quality is so bad. It's
horrific.
I can never get over watching like old videos and just realizing every video we had like watched back then, it just was like rubbing sand in our eyes.
Yes. Oh my gosh. It's such garbage. Okay. Anyway, they were just transition videos. So we could make absolute nonsense. And we did quite a bit. And so this was one of our favorites here when we found out how to crop. I'm just going to swing this over here, chat. I know this is real clumsy, but it's beautiful. I wanted to have this. Oh, right. You can't see my screen right now. Let me make sure here we go. Okay. Oh, wrong one. There it is. Okay. I'm going to full screen this. Make sure we're at max volume here.
Oh, I missed that truck.
I'm going to crank some computer audio up here a bit. Okay, chat. Are you ready?
At one point, YouTube muted the video because I used Duel of the Fates.
Oh, that's right. Okay, the volume's super quiet. I'm going to crank it here. Hang on. crank that audio, and then let me crank my computer audio itself here. I think my computer audio might already be cranked. It is. Thank you. Okay. Well, here we go. This is going to be as loud as it gets, y'all.
Oh, man.
Look at both of our hair. Oh, my gosh.
All right, well, good luck with that, man. See you later.
Hey, Steve.
Hey.
So I had just seen him get in the car and drive away, and now I'm seeing him again. And it is Duel of the Fates.
To bring that hair back.
Man, that hair, I love it. And I think about it sometimes, but it took me legit half an hour and 45 minutes to, like, make it look okay in the morning.
Dude, I always love, like, your so confused and shocked look is, like, the best acting ever. I mean, it's great.
Oh, thanks, man. They offered me an Oscar, but,
this was the hard one. I had to sprint.
You did. You went full sprint. No, not that. That wasn't it. This wasn't the full sprint. That's Jeremiah. The full sprint's coming up here in a sec. I remember this. Because you went all the way around.
All the way around.
Right here. This was it.
And then, like, right now, I just turned on the view.
You're running all the way around through the children's. And then...
You're like, what? And then this was where the first movie magic happened.
Right, yep, this is when we first learned how to do it. Whoa! Oh, that's good comedic. That's real good comedic shot right there. I've forgotten about that. I don't even notice the other you walking from behind. I can't, we don't know. I don't know what I'm saying there either. Chat, don't worry.
Well, at one point, I wanted to try to also be sitting in that chair, but it just didn't work out.
There's our Scooby-Doo moment here.
My favorite's when I wave at myself.
Yeah. So ridiculous. I love it. I've always wanted to make a video like this. Yeah, and you just wave at yourself. So good. I got like an arm flail going as I'm running here. The sign says clone machine. I know, the music is great, huh, Ranger?
So in the past, when I was younger, I dealt with a lot of body
image. Oh my gosh, that was magical. I can't even with that. That was so good. I'm so glad I have that now, too. Like, that is that is something
and on,
that
on
I
that
have.
Page, you'll find the, wait, what? We did that stomp video.
Gosh. I'd forgotten about that stomp video.
Yeah. Man, I thought that we did a lot better making it grumpy than we did.
There are so many things that I would have thought we did a lot better with, but going back and just imagining, right, just like thinking to myself, like, no way, there's no way. Okay, well, Jonathan, man, I'm super glad you're here. We're going to talk more about Broadway, and we're going to talk more about what you got going on here, but before we do that, do you want to play some Unravel?
Let's unravel this thing.
Yeah, dude. Okay, so here's Unravel, guys. We went through a quick cutscene at the beginning where I'm the red one, by the way. I was in a boat. Yeah, go ahead.
Da-ba-dee-da-ba-da.
Yeah, you're blue. Da-ba-dee-da-ba-da. Yeah, exactly. I was in a boat, and is it really that quiet? The game seems super quiet. Anyway, I can do this. No, you keep pushing. I'm so sorry. So a trouble that I have sometimes is that because I'm playing through a capture card. Oh, right. Stand close to another player on hold triangle to hit your ride. Oh, it's loud on you? Okay. I can't hear it for whatever reason anymore. But I'll turn it down to where it's normally supposed to be, right around there. Yeah, I don't know why I can't hear it at all on mine. Okay. There we go. I had to turn on my game audio.
I'm tangled all up in you.
There we go.
Whee!
Normal. Okay, I'll turn up just a smidge. It gets loud sometimes. But anyway, I was on a boat, and the boat crashed, and I had, like, one yarn string hanging from it. It was, like, a human-sized boat, to be clear. I was, like, a doll on this boat. And, oh, yes, I forgot about that. I have, like, a standard look that I do here. Hang on. Appearance. I always go with, I do three head, worried eyes, falling apart body, and then the grayish color. There it is. Wait, no. There's a darker one. Where is the... There's like a dark gray. There it is. That's me right there.
Oh, wait. One sec.
Oh, I'm sorry.
That's okay.
Yeah. You're good. You're good. So anyway, there's a thread that's hanging off of me, and then I wash up on shore, and now the thread's tied to another person. The Unravel games themselves are actually based on memory. Let me know when you're ready, Johnny.
Okay, I'm good.
Are all about memory and just going through memory. And the first one is so beautiful in the way that it's, you know, you're literally pulling on a thread of memory that you're going through somebody's life. This one is very similar in that you're going through memory, but there are two people now. And so, we'll go through this. And you're always following this really pretty light here that's going on. But yeah, Johnny, one of the troubles that we're going to have here is that because I'm playing through a capture card, I have just the slightest delay.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So here, you jump up there. And then I think I hit. Oh, no. Jump. I'm trying to remember how to climb. Yeah. I just hold L2 and I can climb after you. So when we're struggling. Okay, so you can just hold L2 and climb up to me.
Noise.
There it is. You see that Key and Peele sketch noise?
Yeah.
It's so ridiculous. I've seen the GIF 150 times, and then finally, I literally like 2 days ago, I looked it up, and I was like, oh, this is it.
Oh, no.
It's hilarious. Very Key and Peele. Okay, 1, 2, boom, boom. I'm so good at games. Boom, boom, boom.
Magic.
I know. I have, to be clear, played this game to completion, I think, twice. I didn't, 100% it, but I played it to completion on my YouTube channel with my co-host, Kyle Fox, which you guys know from the Nerdy Gritty, our podcast. But then I've played it with my kids as well. They love this game, so it's a good game.
I played it
the
first time yesterday, just to, like, make sure I wasn't completely horrible at it.
How did you R2 to Spider-Man? R2 and then there we go.
Oh, yes.
How did you, find out about this game? Because you were one who, me, like, hey, I got this game called Unravel. Have you heard of it? And I was like, yes, I sure have. Yeah.
So I think I saw one of my friends playing Unraveled, and then, I was like, oh, that's interesting looking. And, then I saw that there was Unraveled 2, and I was like, oh, co-op, that sounds even cooler. So I downloaded it and prepped to, like, be able to play it at some point, and
so close.
And so I was like, you know, you were talking about like a co-op game, and I was like, oh, maybe this game that I never have played yet, we could try.
Yeah. And so it ended up being perfect.
That's my favorite games in the whole world. So.
Just because I love like, kind of artsy, indie games like this. They're very much my jam.
Yeah.
And thank so it, this is definitely one that when it came out, I was like, yes. What kind of games do you typically play?
So recently, well, the last 2 weeks has been Hogwarts Legacy.
Yes. I
beat it a couple of days ago.
I'm so jealous.
It was, I mean, like I'm still only like 70%, you know, cause there's a lot of like other little things that you can do here and there. Oh. But, yeah, that's been a lot of fun. And
I did too. Swung too far.
But I've been playing, like Halo came back out, you know, with like a free game on Xbox. And so, oh no.
Dang it. I missed it too.
Oh, I thought it was you.
That will happen a lot, by the way. You'll just be like, oh wait, that's not me. Because
I'm like, dude, I'm doing really well.
And the platforming is so precise that you, no, I'm not going to fail this. All right. You can just climb up after me here.
Yeah. No, I was hoping you made it.
The platforming is so precise that it's almost like playing a song, like a musical type thing. And when you do it well, you imagine that everybody's going to be doing it exactly the same. So if you're watching somebody else do it, it will feel like what you're supposed to be doing too. So yeah, it's not uncommon to do exactly what you just did. All right. Oh yeah, teamwork here. I'm going to hang on to this. You head on up.
This was difficult to do when I tried to do it by myself.
There we go. Champions.
Yeah.
Okay, right. What am I doing?
We can do this.
There we go. I keep trying to think that I can like climb up one side of the wall like in Hollow Knight or something like that, but you can't.
there was another game I had kind of told you about that I started playing on the Switch called Towerfall.
Oh, yeah.
And it's, man, it's so much fun. I took my Switch home for Christmas, and so I was playing with my nephews with them and everything, and, man, it's so fun. It's kind of like the old, you know, Mario, where it's, like, one screen, but you can, like, go through the walls.
Yeah.
And, like, if you drop down underneath the bottom of the screen, you just come back out the top. But you're, like, shooting arrows at each other, you know, and so you're trying to eliminate each other and... Oh, man, it's so much fun.
See you around, Raintree. Christian Ninja Man, hey, welcome. Thanks for the lurk, brother. Always nice to have you here. Yeah, oh, wow, I just missed, 100% missed. I know Towerfall because there's a barcade near us that does Towerfall tournaments, and it's like a wall-sized screen. At least they used to. I haven't been in a long time. I would go because... did we run out?
Oh, you got to make a knot.
Yeah. Oh, that's grid. Right. That's right. I got to hit the square button. Okay, now you do it on the other side. Jump over, hit the square. There it is. We did it.
Whee!
But we would go and announce tournaments for my old YouTube channel, my old Let's Play channel. And so there were times that we would... oh, that's right. We have to do hints here.
Yeah, I got stuck there for so long. I was like, I don't know what to do.
Yeah, we would announce it like sportscasters, but more comedic style. So it was always a lark. Always quite amusing. Right. Okay, you got it. Good work. I'm glad that you're here to help guide me here. Nope.
Oh, no.
No. Got to get it all the way across.
Teamwork.
Boom.
Makes the dream.
There it is.
Nice.
Yeah.
Towerfall, that's a fun one for me. I love that one. And when they brought back Halo, oh my goodness, it was like you got on and you hear that like choral, you know,
oh yes, dude.
And I'm like, dude,
that is the classic stuff right there. I watched a video a while back on why people think that game music isn't as good as retro games, like that retro game music is better than modern games.
Mm-hmm.
I just pulled the floor out from under you to make you climb up. I'm so sorry. But they were talking about how, oh goodness, hang on. I don't know what just happened to me.
You got this.
There we go. Had to get some tea. Okay. Their point was that gaming music back in the day had like three chords to deal with, and therefore it just became really catchy. Like the whole goal was to be super hooky with your music because you had so little that you could actually deal with. But their whole like comparison was, let's compare it to Halo here, and you know, hearing exactly that choral thing, you have to let go too. So let go. There it is.
Sweet.
Nice. And just hearing that like choral, those choral voices, and it's like, oh yeah, no, modern gaming music is still spectacular. That's right.
Yeah.
Okay. I'll do the first swing.
Okay.
And
yep.
Boom. All right, now you go.
I'm gonna redo that. And okay.
Nice. And you want to go all the way down. You're gonna swing up. Oh, not like that. Not slamming your skull into the. You have to actually go over.
Okay. For Narnia.
This game is also a lot. Every time you slam into that, I love it. Have you ever played Overcooked?
I haven't.
You want to slide down in this? You want to slide down?
Oh, okay.
Yeah, because we want to do this.
Oh, and then I swing up?
No, now I swing up.
Oh, okay.
Oh, no. Maybe it is you then. Yeah, see if you can swing up.
I gotta remember to let go. Let go, let go! Oh, that was close. All right, we did it.
You got it? Yeah, nice, nice, nice. Okay, cool, cool.
Magic.
But Overcooked is a kind of a co-op cooking game, but you have to like work together, and it's all really fast paced and tense. And so there ends up being a lot of like, I need beef. Bring me the beef. What is wrong with you? You know, things like that. This game is like so gentle and chill. And there are times when it gets like that. Like, no, you can't, you need to.
It's like, come on, just do it right.
Yeah, exactly. Do the things that I'm thinking in my brain without me having to say them.
Exactly.
All right.
Yeah, but oh, you want to go? You swing.
Yeah, sure.
But it was logging back on and being able to play Halo again. Like that was fun.
Halo was never my jam, like as far as first person shooters go. I say that, but I've beaten any Halo that has co-op, I've beaten because I like playing co-op quite a bit, and so me and my friend Josh or Kyle Fox, we've beaten Halo games or like Gears of War, things like that. How do we? Oh right, there we go.
I was like drowning.
Don't do that. I'm told that's bad for you.
Yeah,
I'm told it's not good for your health. Wasabi Jane, hey, glad you're here. This game, I don't know if you ever played the original, Jane, but it is beautiful and gorgeous, and this game has a lot of the same. See what I mean about it being like a song? Like, you and I are perfectly in sync there. Okay.
That's how we roll.
Yeah, you got it. There we go. Cool, cool. Beans. I'm glad you did that, because I was bad. All right, into the bucket.
Into the bucket.
Woo.
Click.
Yeah, solo makes it a lot harder, Wasabi Jane, but playing a co-op is so much fun. But I was just telling Johnny that it's also a lot like, it can get like playing Overcooked, if you ever played that, where there's a lot of like, no, here, you need to grab, no, you grab that. I'll go over here. No, what do you, why? Like, it's like a lot of that goes on.
Do it right. Yeah.
Do you play many co-op games at all, Johnny?
No.
No.
I have downloaded, and I really want to play Sea of Thieves, but everyone that I talk to is like, you need at like a minimum two people, but really you need like five.
That's what I've heard also, that if you don't have a pirate ship worth of people, you're going to get wrecked because everybody else has a pirate ship worth of people. So,
And I'm so far behind, you know, like all the people who would play it have already played it and are over it. And so I'm like, all right, I'll just have it sit there. And then one day maybe, but, I don't know. Well, Heather, my wife and I, we used to play Army of Two.
Yes, dude. This and to me, it's Army of Two is like the comfort action B movies that you know are garbage. You know, like any Jason Statham movie or whatever else. Like, you know, these movies are garbage, but you love it anyway because it's just it's what you want right now. The Army of Two games are exactly that to me.
Yeah, we gotta go back to back.
Yeah. And then you can fist bump after you murder like 8,000 people. You're just you shoot everybody in the face and then you fist bump each other.
Way to go, pal. Yeah.
Yeah. Way to go, pal. You did good murder today, my dude.
But yeah, Heather and I, we used to play Call of Duty, Modern Warfare 2 all the time together. And she keeps, you know, I don't know, like the new Call of Duty, I've tried to get into it. It's just, it's not, it's, I feel like it's more, it feels more like Battlefield now, which isn't a bad thing necessarily, but I don't know, like I just really enjoyed the older Call of Duties, you know, Black Ops and Modern Warfare and stuff before they, you know, they re-released it. But I don't know, now that it's more kind of like Fortnite style, I don't know, you know, it's all right. But she's like, we need to play Call of Duty. And I'm like, yeah. And I mean, I used to pre-order them. Like Modern Warfare 2 came out, I pre-ordered it, and I got night vision goggles with them.
Ooh, wait, in-game like, or like real life?
No, like real life.
Really?
Yeah, I mean, they're like plastic and cheap, and you can only see like 15 feet in front of you.
We gotta save this person here.
Oh yeah, it's awesome though.
So I think it starts with me here, and then you gotta push that thing over there, Okay. On the other hand, sometimes you can just hand the controller to a partner at a difficult spot. High tolerance failure, but one spot where you just could not move forward. That gets real frustrating. I hear you, Jane, where there are times that it's just like, I don't know what to do. I can't figure it out. Or maybe I know what to do, but I just can't seem to do it. And it gets obnoxious. And there are times that I'll be sitting there and I'll be telling the game, like, game, this isn't fun anymore. I don't want to play you. Like, as if it can hear me, you know. Thank you, peasant, for pushing me over here.
You're welcome. I got you, Cam.
All right. Yeah, here we go. We got to. Come on. Would you tie the knot? Me. Here. Me tie the knot. Sure. Thanks, Johnny. I'm yelling at myself here. Woo. No. No.
I'm using you.
That is another thing you can do in this game that is hilarious is somebody's about to make a really big jump and you can grab them with L2 and just stop them so they don't go. Let go. Here we go. All right, come on up.
All right, we got this.
I believe in us. So yeah, as you guys can see, we started the memories here. The first part of it was me failing that jump. The first part of it, we saw a kid, maybe a girl. Oh, dang it. We ruined it. Who lived in some sort of like a group home or something like that. And she wanted to run away. So she just climbed out the window. And here we are now. We're making our way over the roof.
Making our way downtown.
Walking fast, faces past. I'm homebound. All right. I think this is one word. Man, you gotta swing now. Now you gotta do the swinging.
Oh, okay. All right.
Here look at go. Me. You are the swinger now. All right. There it is. You get to know these levels really well and you just start like flying through them, it looks like a dance.
Really?
Yeah. And the music is like this really, really awesome Celtic. You know, like drum beat music, and so it becomes like really appropriate. Oh, hey, not that right. One of us has to stay up there and hold the other one.
Nailed it.
Okay, here you go. Yeah, okay. Because we can do this. Now I'm gonna try and do the dangerous thing and go for the extra special. No, it's okay.
I can do this. I believe in you.
I'm not going to try too many times, chat. If I were playing on my own, this would be like a... No, I'm going to get this, whether we like it or not. Yeah, oh, no, I see. Okay, one more time. One more time. I see what I need to do. Okay. No, too low. There we go. Left, right, and left. Nope. Nope. Okay, whatever. Whatever. Hang on. Nope. Nope. Not that. Dang it. I'm so sorry.
I'm like so concerned about how I'm going to...
How you're going to get down now?
Get down without being electrocuted.
You got this. I believe in you. Oh, wait. Do I have to turn it off, maybe?
Is there maybe.
Oh, no. I see. There's a bridge at the bottom. That's what it is. I'd forgotten about that. Okay. So, tie the knot, me. There we go.
Oh, I see. No!
Why? Why is that what I chose to do with that? Hey, maybe you should go down, Johnny. Maybe,
All right, let's try.
I'll just stand here and let you be the hero here. I believe in you. See what I mean?
I can be your hero, baby. Can I?
Now you gotta leap across.
Yeah. I was so confident.
You even did the wee. Oh, this is glorious. Again, so this game betrays itself in being like such a serious game about memory and childhood and whatnot, with these just absolutely comedic moments. All right. Thunk, 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 thunk. All right. Well, Johnny, hey, while we're going through this next section here, tell us about Broadway Christian Church, man.
It's pretty cool church.
No, thanks for letting us know. Okay. No, just it's pretty cool.
Check it out. Yeah. If you're in the area. So we have it's actually a very interesting church because it's one of the only churches still in the East Valley that are doing a traditional service.
Oh, interesting.
And so
those things are bad memories.
Oh. Yeah, we don't want bad memories.
Yeah.
Whoa, he's reaching for me.
I doubted you for a second because you just took off over there. And
I know, I didn't even know what I was doing. And I was like, here you go. Ah, I got burnt.
So still doing a traditional service in the East Valley, you say? No, is that every service, or do you have like one contemporary, one traditional?
We have two traditional and two contemporary.
There you go.
So a lot of the churches that have moved to fully contemporary, a lot of their people have left. So we do have like a pretty good amount of old people in our church,
right?
Which is also a good thing because, man, our budget is just phenomenal.
I thought I was gonna die for a second there. I'm like, oh, I didn't realize I had to swing across this one. Dang it! But then I made it, and then it's all your fault is really what I'm trying to say here.
But yeah, I cleared that thing right there and went over top of it.
You talk about like having older folk in your church. I was listening to a podcast recently about intergenerational churches and how important it is to have things like that because you'll get churches that have like only young people, and that's where you end up getting a lot of like doctrinal issues because they think about more like cultural relevant type things.
Yeah.
And but if it's a church of only old people, then they end up being stuck in tradition and whatnot. Mm-hmm. And so having an intergenerational church is really vital. You got to jump over, I think, is how we do this.
I push this?
Yeah. I'm trying to remember how we do this. Oh, right. No, I remember. Yeah. Hang on. So you stay over here.
All right. And you're going to push it, and then that way I can jump off of it or something.
Oh, I think I have to push this back, though. You stay up there.
Oh, wait.
You stay up there.
Got it.
And then I push this back like this. And then I'm going to push this over. So you jump on it. Jump on it. Oh, it's okay. Push your side back. Push your tube. Oh, there you go. Yeah, that works. Yeah. Cool. And now I come down here. Yeah, we did it.
We did it. We did it. We did it.
Hooray. Yeah. Lo hicimos. Man, so you knew me when I spoke a whole lot more Spanish than I do now, Johnny. I haven't spoken much Spanish in a long, long time. So I dove back into, not back into, I downloaded Duolingo.
Oh, nice.
To relearn some Spanish for myself, you know, get in touch with my roots and whatnot. And, there's another thing. Yeah, we did the exact same thing.
And then said the same thing too.
Right. But it has been this weird, like, I'm not learning Spanish. It's been like digging up memory more than anything. It's like, wait, I know this. Like, hold on. It's been a really surreal experience.
Yeah. That's interesting.
Okay, wait.
So that's not
there.
Oh, okay. I see. There you go.
Pigeons eating our memories. Get out of here, pigeons.
Yeah, pigeons. Those memories aren't for you. There I go again. I'm like, jump. Oh.
These are fun. Stand out on these shoes. Oh, okay. Yeah.
Yeah, so it's been really cool. Like, we just started a thing with our children's ministry on Wednesday nights. So we have, like, we started this ministry on Wednesday nights called Midweek. And that consists of, I started a young adult ministry because of our older population. We have a lot of ministries for all kinds of ages, but really like 55 plus.
Oh, and like, yeah. Dang it. Hang on.
We have like children's ministry, and we have youth ministry, junior high school. But then also we have like 55 plus ministries. So mm-hmm. I was like, man, we're like kind of missing this gap between, you know, graduated and 55.
Man, that is so, so common for churches, though. Ours is in that same spot. Oh, thank you for being smarter than I am. Ours is in the same spot right now, where we have men's ministry, women's ministry, youth group, children's ministry, you know, whatnot, and no young adult anything. And mm-hmm. so our college age anything. Dang it. Here, see if you can make that swing. I believe in you.
For Narnia.
Nope. The moment you let go, I'm like, that's not it.
Yeah.
Okay, let's see if I can be better at everything. Okay, good. Be better at life, me. I'm such a failure. I'm sorry, Dad. But
ring the bell. Yeah, so it's been really cool watching that grow. I think I'm swinging too much is the issue.
I got
there
it.
We go.
Yes.
I guess I don't have to do it anymore since you made it. I can just
I am the type of person who would want to do it myself though. Okay, now here's the important part. Get on this.
Oh, are we gonna do an Ollie?
And get on. Go! Okay. Kickflip! Yes.
And I join.
Manual. Actually, that's not a manual. It'd be a melon. That's what a melon grab.
Oops. Okay. I'm going to go this way.
Okay. Do it. Make it happen. Ready? Let it go. Come on. Oh, ow. Oh, you didn't hit me. I tried to jump on it. My fault. Okay, but you do have to get on it so we can get to the top.
Okay. Now, do I just try to jump up there?
Yeah, just jump up there now. Come on.
It doesn't work.
I believe in it. No, come on. How do we? Maybe we do have to ride it all the way. Here, get on it. We're going to do this. I believe in us. I like that we keep trying to talk about, like, yeah, ministry and good stuff. And like, oh, no, we got to do this now. There it is. Yeah. Yes.
We did it. So anyway, yeah, so I had Beyond going on is Beyond right here. Logo. Pretty sick.
Oh, nice.
For a while, and then but we kind of wanted to have, like, we wanted to make it more. There were a lot of parents with younger families that wanted to be able to come and be a part of it, but it was like really difficult because there wasn't any childcare or anything like that.
Mm.
And it's really neat because our children's director. Oh, is this a bridge?
Yeah.
No.
Then we gotta push this up. It.
Oh, it is. And then. And then you can tie it off up yep. there. Okay, cool. You started a mentoring program.
Ooh.
on Wednesday nights. So we changed Beyond to start earlier. So it starts now at 5:30, and we do like a free dinner. What am I missing here? Oh, you got to use that to jump. I'm in the way.
Like this. And now you start pushing it back up.
Oh, okay, because we got to bring it with us.
Yep.
So we started doing a free dinner from 5:30 to 6, and then from 6 to 7:30 is, like, that's when our ministry is. At 6 o'clock, we split up, and we have, so the young adult ministry, we also have,
No! Ah! Oh, no! I think one of them needs to hold that. I'll hold it while you jump up.
Okay. And then we also have, the children go and do their thing, and then we also have a recovery ministry that meets the same night. And then there's like an older person's life group that meets. So there's pretty much something for everyone on Wednesdays, which is really cool. So if anyone just like randomly shows up, they can be a part of something.
Nice. That is, I mean, I think it's so undervalued. Hang on, I gotta swing up here. Is the, again, multi-generational nights where there is something, it's not just church where this one thing is for everyone, because, you know, spoiler, a lot of times it isn't.
Right.
But where this is like, hey, there is something for everyone tonight. We're just going to be doing different things. Like, you, there will be something for your age group or gender demographic or whatever else. Mm-hmm. And, but you can all still come together as a family.
Like, yeah,
that's so good.
Yeah, and it's really cool. It's been really neat, like seeing that. But also at the same time, a lot of times they're, you know, the kids get like crazy because they're like, they eat in 5 minutes, and then they're like,
oh yeah, and then they just want to run around
basketball or whatever, you know. And so there's balls flying everywhere
while people are eating.
Yeah, yeah, because it's like in a gym, which is cool. But at the same time, it's like. I think it's fun because it's like you see just community happening.
Oh yeah.
You know, and that's one of the biggest things like that I was wanting, like even at the very basis of it all, that for Beyond we meet, we sit around round tables, you know, so that way at the very basis of community, we're all sitting and like facing each other and being able to talk. And it's been really neat because people will stay like, for like an hour or so after it's over and just like have real conversations and like talk and like create friendships and stuff. And I don't know why it's not letting me.
I believe in you. There it is. Yeah.
Oh. Okay. Oh, this is
it's a wall jump. I see.
Jump. I think.
Yeah.
I should have went to the other wall.
No, it's all right. We got this. I believe in us. I don't think we need to do this, but yes, we got it. Cool.
Oh, okay. Oh, that was just for the extra thing. Okay.
Yeah, you get like extra levels, which will do extra memories and whatnot with these things. So, man, I used to volunteer at a church in college that had the same type of thing where it was an underprivileged area in Southern California. And there were children's, it was basically like there was a children's ministry and a youth group and whatnot. But before that, it was just food. And just that simple act of providing a meal for these people, for some of them, was a huge thing. Like, it was one less night a week that parents had to be concerned. That parents had to be concerned, am I going to be able to feed my family this week? You know, and so it was just such a big deal. So, yeah, having things like that where you're just feeding people and feeding the whole family is such a big deal. I mean, obviously it's also a problem, but I do love that then your kids get rowdy and in there, like, it just shows, again, it's that multi-generational thing, right? Like,
right.
Your church can't get rowdy with kids if it doesn't have any kids, you know?
Right. Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. And then, so then we have also just on Sunday mornings, we have children's ministry. Oh, so the mentoring program, it's been really cool because, she's gathered a bunch of, people from the church, you know, to sign up as mentors. that they get to like come in and like invest in, like, it's like one to two, like one mentor per two kids, and it's or something like that. And it's been really neat. Do you need to?
Oh, yes, I need to swing. That's exactly right. I'm glad you're a smarter human being than I am.
Just occasionally. Oh no!
Just face planted it.
Smack.
Okay, actually, that was it. I could have had it then. Dang it! What is wrong with me? I mean, there's a list, I'm sure. There we go. Now you can
swing from you.
Yeah. There we go.
Which is, oh, watch out for the car.
I will not.
No. Oh man. So that's been really cool. Just seeing,
I love that.
Older people being able to pour back into younger people. Because a lot of times at churches, I feel like that just, sometimes that just doesn't happen, you know? A lot of the older people are kind of like, well, I did my time. I did everything I needed to do. So it's really neat having that.
So we have our kids now in our memories here who they're helpful. Successfully escaped, and now they're here, I got it. It's fine.
I'm coming.
And now they're making their way. We don't even know where. Oh, not there. That's not the place.
Do we need to do it? Wait.
I think now you jump in there. Okay, but now.
Do I need to do the light down thing? Maybe it's left. Maybe it's. Is it a bumper to slide down?
No. Okay, hold on.
Maybe just a better angle. Here, now try. Maybe at this angle.
Okay. Okay, wait. I think push it back to the other side. Okay. Let's do that. Now you climb up here.
Up on top of that?
Yeah. Just climb up. There we go. And then, actually, let me climb up now. Okay, now you jump down again. So there's one of us up here now, and you can go over to the right and
push it
and jump in there. This is nothing. I don't know what I was thinking was going to happen. I've got absolutely nothing. Okay. Oh, no, I'm such a doofus. There's clearly a thing right there that we hang on. Very clearly.
Thanks, chat.
Thanks, chat. Okay.
Just watching a struggle. No, I'm just kidding.
Yeah. Gosh. Okay. Oh, this is a
bridge?
Yeah, bridge.
Oh, here we go. All right.
I believe in you.
Me too.
I'm believing in you less.
I'm believing in climbing. Thank you for rescuing me. Yeah.
I'm always here for you, Johnny. I'm always here for you. Okay.
And then we also have like normal ministries on Sunday morning. Like we have a children's ministry all the way up through junior high as well, just during one of the contemporary services. And then I have junior high and high school on Sunday nights as well. So I've got some busyness going on.
Yeah, I bet. Man, there is a... an amount of underappreciation that families/youth pastors get, because people think, they just do the kids' fun stuff. And it's like, you take care of adults. And really, we can consider adults at one age group, you know, like grown-ups. Maybe you can get like young families to older families, but for the most part, it's adults. But when you're a youth/family pastor and you're doing middle school, high school, college age, and young adults on top of that, like, that is a member of, or an amount of people and different like lifestyles that you have to be aware of. That is just ridiculous. Okay. So now you need to tie that to the thing below there.
Oh, okay. How do I, there we go.
Wasabi Jane, you're working while watching a stream. How could you? You need to quit your job. And,
are you, Can you get through that?
Yeah,
you
just need to come up. No, we're getting up now.
Oh, I see, because I can't go further. All right.
There you go. And I mean, I can just do this now. Yeah.
Yeah.
And yeah. Yes. Yeet. 10 point land. Yeet. All right, get in here.
All right, I'm in. Whee!
Boom. I did it. Now you stay right there because this one is...
I'll make a bridge.
Yeah, that's what we're doing. And I'll push this over here.
Bridge the gap.
There it is.
Very nice, very nice.
Man, we're geniuses, John. Oh!
I'm sorry. Oh. I owed you one.
Fair. I love that it's just as I was complimenting us, like,
no.
Why will the share place say, why?
I don't know.
Hopefully we can like restart it? That was weird.
Hopefully.
Do we have a timed amount? That's ridiculous. I pay you money, Sony. You should not.
Thanks a lot, Sony.
Hey, chat, appreciate if anybody out there can just check for a second why the share play is going to end in 5 minutes. Okay.
Yeah, because we didn't approve that.
Hey, don't die.
That's
my suggestion here.
That's a good suggestion. I'm so scared.
Maybe I can... No, I can't just go in. Go! Yes! Yes!
He's got ups.
It's incredible. Okay, I see. Okay, it wants us to go up. Yeah.
All right, so I think this guy's going to... go down low enough so then we can slide and jump.
Now,
and jump. Whee!
I'm glad you made it. It shot me way over.
That's what you say when you're having fun. You refer to yourself and a bunch of people.
This reminds me of the old Super Mario games.
Dun, dun, dun,
exactly, yes. Okay. You just need to swing below me now. You can just drop. There you go. True. You made it. Yeah. Now, don't hit the guy when you're in your backswing. That's a mistake I have made so many times. All right.
Bloop.
Yeah. Bloop. Just need to punch one of them.
Punching them.
I mean, in so many ways, sure, Mario jumps on top of them, whatever else, but... you're on this like really high precarious thing and there's a living being on the other side and Mario's like boosh, and just punches them right off the fence.
Yeah. It's like, wait a second. All right,
how would the share play session end in 3 minutes? Why? What's happening? Okay, you gotta swing to the other side now.
How do I do that though?
Jump and climb back up.
But I can't.
Oh, because like, the off, wind.
Well, one. Oh.
Okay, hang on. Let me see what I can do here. Hold on.
Yeah.
Huh? Oh, I see what you do. Yep.
First.
Yeah. So we're gonna do. Nope. Why do I keep doing that? It's that quarter second delay. Okay, just drop right there, me. Cool. Okay, tie that off. Thump.
All right. Cool.
There it is.
Recover, and then yeah.
Oh. Nope. Nope, I'll just walk right off the edge. That's the way this works. Okay, hang on. Give me one last try, and if I fail again, I'm going to let you do it.
All right.
It legitimately is the delay on my controller, chat. It is. Okay, you go, Johnny. You got this. Right. I believe in you.
Good. At least one of us does.
At least all one right of us, yeah. It is going to end.
Ooh, so close.
It is going to end the moment... that like right now, like I'm waiting for any second just before you tie it off.
We did it though.
No, we got it. Okay.
Quick. Oh. Of course. All right.
Ha!
This is why we can't go to nice places.
This is why we can't have nice things, man. I did that on purpose. I shouldn't have. I'm so sorry, chat. It's and Johnny. Okay. I 100% did that on purpose.
It's all gravy train.
And this share thing's going to end any second now.
You know what we can do is while we're trying to get reconnected, you can play another.
Yes.
Lamp video.
Come on. Ty. All right. Come on down. I promise you, I won't drop you this time.
Oh, thank you.
You got 60 seconds, I believe.
I believe that we can win. Oh, we might be able to just...
So, yeah, we go boom, 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 boom. Ah, I see the problem here. Yep, you gotta go grab that one.
Is there...
Oh, wait, no, I got it. Yep, hold on. No, stop it. Stop it, I don't want this.
I know. That reminds me of Dimitri Martin when he's talking about volleyball. He's like, in every sport, everyone, you know, wants the ball. But in volleyball, it's like the opposite. It's like, all right, we don't want this. You know, and it's like,
so you jump on that now.
We don't want this. I don't want it. I don't want it. I don't want it. All right, let's try this again.
Jump on that thing.
It's ended.
Oh, no. The Shesson play ended. Okay, drop another video in the chat while we try and reconnect here. Why is the share session thing timed? That's obnoxious.
Yeah, that's very, very dumb. Oh, man. This was after I got a haircut.
Invite to game? No. Okay, maybe we have to...
Do I need to go back in it? I don't remember.
Where's the... Oh, here it is. Play with the visitor. There. Okay. In theory, you
we're
should
gonna
be able to.
Where we were.
You'll be able to do this. But still, did you drop it? Because I do want to show another video.
Yeah, I put it in Discord.
Yes. Okay. One more time, chat. You're going to get to see behind the curtain for half a second here as I. Oh, yeah. This lamp video. Man. So good. Okay, here we go.
Oh, that's me. I got bigger. I'm trying to think, like, look and see what I need to grab a hold of, though.
So goofy.
I'm like so excited.
Oh, Danala, sorry. Danala, glad you're here though. Hey, man. By the way, Danala, so we did a good job. Jim Jeremiah.
Yeah.
So goofy.
Yay! And then this sneak away is the best sneaking I've ever seen.
Oh my gosh. Magical. Absolutely magical. I'm just going to pause this. Oh, this was nothing, huh? This was just you and I driving somewhere.
Yeah.
I've forgotten about that. Like you and I were going shopping or something like that. Anyway, Danala, I fixed my... Remember, because during Hogwarts Legacy, everything was cutting out every once in a while.
Oh, yeah.
I just had to run updates is what it was. I had an update on stuff. So, yeah, I got that fixed. Thank you, Danala, for your help here. Johnny, you got to jump on the thing to the right there.
Oh, I just jump on it. Okay.
Just jump on the thing. Maybe not that, actually. Hang on. You got to get back in here. Okay. Come on.
Yeah. Maybe
it was exactly that, Danala. For some reason, an update will fix this. No. Okay. Wait. I know now. Okay. I need to push this over, and
Yes.
To do this. Yep.
You jump on it, and then I get shot over that thing. And
yeah. Get in there. Thump. Wee. And then, okay, wait. Yeah, no more interruptions from the cat. And we just pushed that. Yes. Got it all fixed. Oh, wait. I got us all tied up
here. We both climbed.
There we go.
All right.
Speaking of Alligato, Wasabi Jane. You were here. I was just telling Johnny that I have dipped into Duolingo. I'm 100% Mexican, and I used to speak great Spanish, but I haven't had to in like 20 years, and so I've lost most of it. So I've been dipping back into Duolingo to try and relearn Spanish, and it's been like I'm not learning. I'm just like trudging up memory, and it's the weirdest feeling. Like phrases just come to my mouth like, oh, I knew that, and I didn't know I knew that. Weird.
Yeah, it just pours out, and you're like, huh.
Yeah.
There was this movie with Brendan Fraser called Bedazzled. And
yes.
His first wish, he was like, he was Spanish, and this person comes up and starts speaking Spanish to him, and he's like, oh, lo siento, no hablo en español. ¿Qué?
Oh,
yeah. ¿Hablo español?
Exactly that.
He's
yes.
like saying all these phrases. He's like, man, if my high school Spanish teacher could see me now.
Man, I saw that movie. It's Brendan Fraser and what's her name? Dang it. Who played the devil? Yeah, Liz Hurley. That's right. Elizabeth Hurley. And I watched it in theaters, and it was hilarious, and I loved it. And it is another comfort film. Like, and honestly, in all honesty, it's fine. It's a pretty good movie, but it's a comfort film. You watch it just to laugh and smile and enjoy
things. Like Blast from the Past, also Brendan Fraser.
Yes.
You know?
Yes.
Oh, so good.
But not like Biodome, which is actually a bad movie.
Right. But people think it's not.
Okay. Yeah, so that's something that people, I wish a lot more people realized, is that a movie can be bad and you like it. That's okay. Mm-hmm. There are tons of bad movies, like the Resident Evil films. The Resident Evil films are not great movies, but I love them. They're so fun to watch. And that's okay. You know, my friend, my co-host Fox loves, wait. Okay. Now I do this. Now you push me to the other side. I see it here. Got it. Oh, these are the challenge areas. That's right. But my co-host loves all the Fast and the Furious movies. Wait, hold on. And he knows they're not great.
Right.
Wait. I need to come down. I need to hang. There we go. Oh, yeah, now push me over.
Well, yeah. And they're basically, we're like stretched to the limit.
Okay, hey, I'm going to come back up.
Can I go down? Okay, there we go.
No, oh, I just clipped through the pipe. Okay. How do I? Oh, I guess I'll just let you up. Is how we do this.
Oops.
Can you push it back over?
Yeah. All right. Maybe. I don't know. Oh, maybe you can swing down now?
Or maybe I climb up here. Like this.
Oh, yeah. Perfect. Yeah.
And I can push this over. Yeah. There it is. And now I'm just going to... No! You were climbing. I'm so sorry. That's my fault. 100%.
It's all great.
Wait, where am I going? Okay, there. Now. I'm sorry, chat. RIP your ears. Okay, right. I got to hang down.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, cool. We have a lot more.
For whatever reason, it
space now
let us
time.
Have a lot more. Okay, now.
Now you jump. Or, yeah.
There it is. Now you climb back up here. We got it now. We got it. No problem.
This ain't no thing.
Okay, now you climb up here.
There we go.
Now you jump over.
Whee.
And now I'll jump over too. What are we saving here?
We're saving another Yarny.
A little pink Yarny. I made a Yarny. Oh, man.
Instead of playing Narnia, for Yarnia.
For Yarnia, dude. That's exactly it. Okay,
I'm
hold on.
Ashamed that it took me that long.
I have something to show you guys. Hang on.
I'll entertain everyone. Why do you never see elephants hiding in trees? Because they're really good at it.
I love the first Unravel game so much. I made a Yarny.
Oh, dude.
And he's awesome. Real wonky and goofy looking, but I love him. He's That's wonderful. Perfect. So I just want to show you guys that I have a Yarny that I made.
You know what? If you ever make another one, you should put like a, I don't know, like levels. The thing, like a pull string. You know, something that retracts, so you could put yarn in there and then like pull it out. And
oh,
then,
that'd be back. Cool. That'd be very cool. Okay, how do we get to this other level now? Is it we gotta?
It's a great question. Oh,
and then oh, yeah, that's all oh, right. Okay, let's go upward. So push that to the right.
This thing?
Yeah. Well, the other right, but There you go.
Oh, I see. In my mind, I'm like, I'm standing on the right side. Yeah. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Okay. Here we go. Next level. Little frogs.
Little frogs.
In which right is wrong and we refuse to accept it.
Froglets.
Given Yarny several years ago, before I got a dog, he became my adventure buddy. Unfortunately, he was lost when my car was stolen. No.
That's so sad.
Yeah, even when you get replacements, it's not the same. Now, did somebody make it for you, Wasabi Jane, or was it like someone that was bought? Oh, we held hands for a second, Johnny.
We love each other.
We do love each other. It's wonderful.
I feel like we have to do something over here first.
Oh, can we push this? I bet you we can push this flower pot over if we work together.
Are things like double heavy? No.
No.
Somehow we got to get up and over this thing.
Right.
I feel like.
Nice work.
When in doubt, shoot your yarn out.
That's what I always say. No. Okay, say that. Yeah. No human being has ever said that. Official license one, I think. Yeah. The friend pre-ordered Unravel and received him and just passed him along. Oh, that's nice. Very kind. And so the other ones that you have, were they all?
Nope. That's my bad.
It's fine. We didn't agree on who was swinging. You swing. I'll just hang out here. Because I'm going to talk to Wasabi Jane. You said you've received replacements. Have they also been official license ones or are they handmade ones? Yeah. There we go. Okay. Yes. I'm very nice. So good at this. Nope. It's okay. We're just going to go like this and yeah. Nope. It didn't work.
Is there something else? Oh, we got a swing.
Oh, that's right. The team swing.
All right. You swing this time.
Yep. Ha-ha! There we go. Now you swing. Yes. Teamwork. I'm told it makes the dream work.
Sometimes, man. Oh, I'm going to push.
Why do we do this? Let's talk. You're going to push. I'll stay on the bear. You got it.
I'm like, I'm going to try to wait to push until you're on top of it. Man, I love that they, like, paid attention to physics.
Okay. This is wonderful. Wasabi Jane says, the second one is from Etsy. Not sure where the other one came from, but a friend wrote up a whole adventure about how he ran away to start a life of crime when his car was stolen, but had a change of heart and came home. That one has a homemade COVID mask and some bandages. That is wonderful. I get that it's not the same, but also I would love that one equally but differently if I were you. Oh, keep going. Go. Something bad happened here. So you can see we have bad memories chasing us, and you can also see that for some reason the dinner got wrecked in the background. This game. Oh, we gotta get up. Dang.
Gotta get up.
Oh, we didn't have to get up. That was for an extra thing. Move. My fault. My hubris. I'm so sorry. We gotta run at the same time. Okay, ready, set, go. We don't want your nonsense. Bad memories. I'll push that cake over. I don't even care. I don't care about the extra thing right now. We're running from our memories because that's how you solve your problems, by running from them.
Yeah. It's the most healthy way.
It's the healthiest way to run and never look back and pretend it never happened.
Just shove it deep down inside.
And never speak of it again. Hey, chat, don't do that. That's all jokes. Don't do that. It's very emotionally unhealthy.
I saw a meme today that said, when your sarcasm is so on point that a lot of your friends think that you're actually dumb.
Oh, I see. Okay, wait. You get on there. Okay, and then now I have to... Oops. Get this all the way over here. And go... Nope. Okay. Oh, man. Okay, I can do this. It's okay. I believe in me. And go. Nope, nope, nope. That ain't it. That's not going to be it, huh? Is there a way that...
Steve, how do you feel about Star Wars?
How do I feel about Star Wars? Very positively. Star Wars is very good.
The Mandalorian.
About the Mandalorian? Is that what you said?
Yeah.
Very positive about the Mandalorian. Oh, good. It's very, very good.
Have you watched the first episode yet?
Oh, no, not the new one. I haven't seen it. I forgot it just came out yesterday.
Yeah.
Is it controversial?
No, I just...
Oh, okay. Man, did you hear that Luke Skywalker was in Book of Boba Fett? Minor spoilers here. It was Mark Hamill's face, Mark Hamill's voice, Mark Hamill's everything. And he did not act a single second of it.
Yeah.
It was all from AI produced from a like deepfake technology from a radio show they did of Star Wars a whole jillion years ago, like back in the 80s. And so they just had his voice recorded a million times. He just stood there.
I was watching what you were doing, and all of a sudden I just disintegrated.
That was hilarious. I was watching you. Oh, it's chasing me. Oh, interesting.
Oh, weird.
Oh, yeah, it's chasing you.
Why is it?
No, no, we're hooked. We're hooked, Jonathan. We're hooked. Yeah.
Okay, I'm climbing. I'm climbing. Climb.
Ah! Run. I can't believe this just happened.
Oh, no.
Oh,
no,
wait. It's okay. Yeah. It's not okay. Okay, I see.
Okay. Is this like the ghost in Mario? It only chases you when you're not facing it.
Okay, now you need to get up there. Here, I'm going to come over here. Come chase me. Chase me. Oh, no, it got me.
I'm trying to figure out what triggers it to go to you.
Proximity is my guess. No. No. Okay. Okay, let me get up here. Ooh, this is a speed. It's speed. I am speed.
I am speed.
Okay, you go. Get up there. Get up there. Go. Okay. Oh, no. That dude just... He just shot right at me. Dang it.
Aggroed you, yeah.
Okay, I'm going to go this time. Ready? Boom. 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 You stay right there.
Oh. No.
Nope. That wasn't it, huh? That wasn't it.
I hit my head.
Ow. Okay. Maybe I can... Yeah! Yes! Let's go!
Wee!
That was incredible. Oh, wait. We need to get back up
Yahoo.
Here.
Yahoo!
How do you feel about the new Mario movie?
I'm very excited for it.
Me too.
Hopeful.
Yes.
I know a lot of people have, like, do you want to swing up there and get that thing?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. I got really excited for it because we watched, what did we watch in 3D? Maybe Avatar, the new Avatar.
Oh, yeah. I haven't seen that yet.
We watched that in 3D, and there was a 3D Mario preview. So I was like, I got to see it in 3D.
3D gives me headaches, unfortunately. There we go. All right. Now I'll just swing across here. Yeah, 3D gives me headaches. And to me, 3D technology is a lot like VR technology, where it's going to be pretty cool and an interesting... Oh, there's a kill you thing there. It's going to be pretty cool, interesting technology.
Mm-hmm.
Forever, and that's about it. It will never be like the absolute, this is the thing type tech.
Right.
It will always be a peripheral, I guess is what I'm saying here. Ooh, man, these guys are just leaping out of nowhere.
I feel right into it.
It's okay. We got this. Ha ha! Go, go, go. We don't want your garbage.
Okay, definitely another time where I thought I was you.
Man, I'm doing so good.
I'm like, I nailed that.
I nailed that. Now you are nailing it.
Whee! Yeah.
And... Yes. Yes, yes, yes.
Did you see Pascal. Oh,
Pedro Pascal.
He made, it might have been Saturday Night Live.
Just go, 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 go.
Post-apocalyptic.
Yeah, the Mario Kart.
Yes, yeah.
That was so funny.
So good.
It's me, Mario. I'd watch it, man. If they made that show, I'd watch the crap out of it.
Don't attack me.
No, no. Don't. At least you ask kindly, you know?
I'm like,
hey, don't.
I should have said please.
Yeah. Oh, darn. That's what undid us. Okay, get back here. I think is our safe spot. Yeah. Oh, here we go. Now you can climb up.
There's a spider.
Pedro Pascal is a blessing to our race, a gift from the Lord to us. That man is such an incredible actor.
He's so good.
Yeah. All right. Did you see The Unbearable Weight of Talent or something? Or the Nick Cage movie with Pedro Pascal?
I don't think so.
Oh my gosh. It is so good and ridiculous. Okay. I think what we need to do. Okay. Come on down.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. I see what we're doing here. That right there.
Watch out for the nightmare.
Yep.
And then you got to go back to the beginning.
Yep. We got to let that nightmare recede, though.
Is he going to attack me?
He's coming for you. Come on down. There you go. Okay. You're out of its range now.
Yeah, but it's.
He's looming.
All right.
Okay, wait. No!
I was too loud. Sorry.
I know. We're both of us. You're just yelling. Sorry, chat.
Why does it want us to go up there? Oh, just eventually. Okay, I see.
Okay, now. Yeah, okay, cool, cool beans. Cool, cool, cool beans.
Stop chasing me.
No, no. Monsters.
What?
Okay. There we go. We're ignoring. Oh, no, we're not ignoring the shiny. Okay, you go down there now.
Going? Okay.
Yeah, go.
Stay away from me.
No. Okay, hold on. I got a. That thing was right up on me, man. That thing was straight creeping, yo. Okay, you ready?
Yes.
On your mark, get set, go.
We did it.
You did. We did it. Look at this. Boom. I wonder if the children went through a cave as well, or if they're like above us right now.
Yeah.
And our memory is just traveling through the gopher hole underneath.
The hole. Like it wanted us to go up and over, but we like fell the rocks gave
away. Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's fair. Oh, yeah. And see, there they are. They ran away. Oh, watch turkey. No.
Oh, my goodness.
Go. No. We're not food. Leave us alone. Good.
Oh man, we're
no.
So good.
Ha! Can't get us up here, turkey.
That was clutch.
Oh, you can wait for us down there, though. You don't want any of your nonsense. Okay, hang on.
Are we gonna bridge? All right.
I think that's what we're doing here. Oh no, no, oh no, we're. I see. You're coming down here.
You gotta move that can?
How do we.
You distract this can?
Yeah, no, that's exactly what's happening. I'm distracting him.
He ate me.
So I gotta hang. I gotta hang to distract him. I see it now. He wants nothing more than a tasty, tasty treat. Okay, go move the can. You got this. Okay.
Now what? How do I distract?
Can
I? Oh, I do this.
There you go.
Hi.
There.
What's up, turkey?
Nice. 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 Ha!
Turkeys are dumb.
Yeah, they're stupid. We should eat them.
But only like specific times of the year. Unless they're thin, sliced really thin.
Unless they're sliced super thin, then it's fine whenever, you know? Get up here! That was incredible. I feel alive.
Oh,
okay, I think
bad.
You're going to have to swing underneath me. Oh, turkey.
Is that a bridge?
No, what? I think you're going to... Oh, you got it. Yeah, yeah. Nice, nice. Okay. Cool. And you get... Nope, that's not going to make it. Help me, hurry. Jump. Get up top.
No.
No, dang it.
I was like, what's he going to do?
Okay. Oh, yeah. Here we go. Oh, no, I just straight up missed.
There Watch out, that turkey's coming.
There he is. You know that it ate you, right? You didn't think you were me that time?
Yeah, no, okay, it was yeah. me. I could tell because my controller was like, bzzz.
All right. Whoa, that was so close. Dude, get up here, hurry.
I was pushing the wrong thing. I was trying to swing. And
oh my gosh, I love this game so much. Bag. Okay, it's okay. Just little, no, it's not okay. It's un-okay. It just flung you. Did you see that?
Opposite of okay.
Do you ever read Penny Arcade, the comic?
I haven't in a long time.
It's a video game webcomic. There's this one a while back in which... all right, we can make this jump. In which one of the characters just happens to be talking to Jesus for whatever reason. And he just says, Jesus, tell me something good. Real secret about creation. And he's like, turkeys? They were originally going to be the dominant animal. It's like, what? What happened? And Jesus is like, we just made them too delicious.
He just made it delicious. He's like, that's on me.
Yeah. Yes.
Did it.
Can't eat us, turkey. Ooh. Can't eat. Oh, maybe you can. I see. You didn't make it over here. There are the kids back there also running from the turkey.
You know what game I really miss?
What's that?
Flappy Bird.
I never played Flappy Bird, but do we just run? Is that what we're doing here?
I think so.
We're just running, yeah, that's it. We're just straight up. Oh, no. Oh, he does. He just flings you. That turkey's like, yeah. Man.
So I actually considered when they banned it from. We both just didn't jump at all. When they banned it from the store where you couldn't download it anymore,
right?
People were like selling their phones for like $800 because it was pre-installed.
It's so weird.
It was so weird.
My claim to fame with Flappy Bird was that I got eaten by the turkey again. Was that I took somebody's like score, Googled, okay, what's like the highest medal you can get? Platinum medal, cool. And then I shopped in that I got like 1,011 or something like that. And then I just did this whole, and then I posted it online and everyone was like, whoa.
Here we go.
Nope, that wasn't it. We got to go at the same time. We'll count to three. We'll do a 1, 2, 3. Okay. Boom. Nope. See, that wasn't it, Jonathan.
I always like think I'm going to overshoot it. So I always
pull back for just a half a second there. You're good. All right. That was the key moment right there. Look at us in sync. Okay. 1, 2, 3, go. No. 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 You can't have us.
Checkpoint reached. We're basically professionals at this game.
Of course. No other human being has gotten as far as we have.
Do I need to go distract?
Oh, yeah, yep, that's what happens. He was looking upward. I thought he was distracted by the light, and so I took that risk. But okay, here, you go. You go be a turkey distraction.
Hi.
And I'll come over here.
Turkey.
And now I'll be a turkey distraction. Do you hear that in Canada, there are some pigs that were allowed to go feral? And they... dang it. How do we get up there?
There's a thing, a jump point to the left.
Okay.
Like a swing point.
Oh, I see it. Yep. Farmers who had pigs then decided they didn't want them anymore, let them kind of go feral. They were now... Oh, I'm sorry. I wasn't distracting them well enough.
Okay.
they let the pigs go, and now the pigs have created, like, a pig society that are outsmarting hunters and like ruining crops and things like that, and they've had to like bring in what?
I don't know.
I was doing a good distracting, wasn't I?
I thought you were too.
Okay. Maybe I gotta like jump up and down and wave my arms around. Hey, turkey! Hey! Hey, over here! Hey! Hey!
Do you need to swing? Oh, can you jump and swing?
Oh, yeah, I bet you're right. Huh.
There we go.
There it is. No!
I was so confident.
What was that? He ran over to me, then changed his mind. It's like he knew you were there.
As soon as he went to the left, I just jumped.
All this to say that the pigs are like way smarter than normal animals right now, and they're outsmarting hunters, and they're calling it Judas pigs, where they catch one pig, put a GPS collar on it, and let's see if you can get up there, put a GPS collar on it, and then let it guide them back to where the rest of the pig colony is. Because like they've developed how to be nocturnal, they've developed how to like avoid hunters. Like there's these just super smart pigs.
Yeah.
No, ha 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 ha! You can't have me. Thanks, awesome. Johnny, for saving my life. Anyway, this turkey is like that. He's an ultra smart turkey.
Mm-hmm.
That's what Canada gets for being Canadian.
I've been trying to. Oh, whoa! Slow motion. A friend of mine, so I used to play D&D a lot, and everyone that like I played with moved away or just moved too far in the valley. So I haven't been able to play for a while, and so I'm trying to find like a community to maybe even just play online or do one shots or something like that. Okay.
I love me some D&D. Man.
Okay, just us two.
Yeah, just me and you. That's it.
Okay, maybe there's like a... Oh, no, I don't know. I was like, we can find some random person to like DM or something.
Yeah. I'm already DMing two campaigns and in the process of doing a third right now, so I can't DM, but I'll love to play.
Well, and that's what... Do you prefer DMing or just playing?
In this case, I would prefer to play. I enjoy DMing. I really do. Mm-hmm. But... I'm currently DMing two D&D campaigns, one me and my wife, two, and then two married couple friends of ours. The six of us have a party that we've been playing for a little more than a year now.
Oh, nice.
And then we've actually been playing with one of those married couples for about 10 years now, longer than that, maybe even 20 years now, a long time.
Not the same game. But just
not the same game. The longest game we've ever played was 4 years. We had a 4-year campaign that we took from level 3 to level 19.
Holy cow.
Yeah.
Wild.
And it was awesome. Like, we still talk about it and remember it, but...
Yeah. I had never played until I moved here, to Arizona and started working at this church. And Dan Locke, who you had on a few weeks ago...
Yeah.
He was like, hey, do you want to like try to play D&D? And I was like, sure, I've never played. He's like, yeah, me either. So we were like, I was like, okay, like, let's do it. So I'll go push this one. Can I like hold on to it or something?
I wonder if you gotta go over it. Yeah, like that. And then
do I push this?
Maybe.
Makes you to be able to swing.
Oh, yeah. There it is. Nice. Nice. Okay. You're right. I got to swing. You're right.
And then you get to one side. Somehow I got to get to the other side.
Okay. So I'm on this side. How do we get you to that side, though?
So do I need to...
I think we've only got half of it here. I'm coming down. Okay. So let's...
Oh, if you can somehow raise me up,
and then I swing over
it, and then go back and push it to get you up, and then I can just climb up.
Okay, I need to get over it first, though, so.
Oh, okay, let's do this. I got it. We're going to pull it with our tails. Okay. So come this way. Follow me. Oh, wait. No, yeah.
Just pull it down this way, right? Come on.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, no, this is good, because...
Yeah, you push, and then I'll swing to the left first. Oh.
That wasn't it. Dang it. We want to be... Oh, no. There we go. We got it. That's it. Now I'm over here. Okay. Now what did you say we need to do?
Okay. So I'm going to push this first, and then you swing to the left.
Got it.
First.
Definitely, Sisa. Do another one-shot with us. Man, we need to... that's Elisa. She is a good friend of mine. Wow, that was too much, but it's okay. I can make my way back up.
Because now you push it.
Oh, I see. I swing
to the right, and then you just climb up.
Yeah, nice. But we did a one-shot. I did a Christmas one-shot for them a while back. Where did you guys fight the Grinch or the Krampus? I think you guys fought the Grinch. I did a Krampus one for my other party, too. But yeah, I'm DMing one for two married couple friends of ours. Then I'm DMing in every other week one for my 10-year-old son and three of his friends. And intimidated by Gino. Gino, there was this little camp of bandits. And one of the gals that played with us, she was a barbarian. And she came in. And I don't know if it was like a good charisma, whatever. Of course, the classic thing happened where he fell in love with her. And... nice, there it is. And so now he's like her husband type, you know, pet that she carries with him. Anyway, so there's the one with my 10-year-old son and three of his friends. And do you watch Avatar The Last Airbender? Johnny? Oh, Johnny's gone. Goodbye, Johnny.
Hi.
He's back. There we go. Hey, what happened?
I don't know. All of a sudden it just... it like when you went away, so I hung up and rejoined.
Well, we're here.
Oh, we did it? Okay.
Yeah. Cool. Did you watch Avatar The Last Airbender?
Yes.
I kickstarted the Avatar The Last Airbender tabletop TTRPG. And so it's run by Powered by the Apocalypse, and I don't know how to play Powered by the Apocalypse. And so I've been researching that, and that's the third campaign that I'm preparing to DM. So.
Okay.
Yeah.
Awesome.
All that said, I do a lot of DMing. What do we do? Oh, wait. Maybe we need that brick?
Oh, maybe so.
Yeah. I bet you we... hang on. Tie off right here.
Lasso it.
And then...
oh, is it
here? Yeah.
Okay. Smart.
This way. There it is.
You know what's funny, though, about D&D? So... you know, Dan was like, hey, do you want to play this? And I was like, sure, you know, I've never done it. And he's like, me either. Like, let's do this. You might need to remake the bridge and push a little further. I think I was in the way. Or
come on.
Or something.
Maybe we have to push it together. What's happening?
Oh, I did it.
You were somehow. Oh, I'm at the edge of my rope here.
Oh, okay.
Our strings have limits, and I was at the edge of mine.
Yes. So we played, and I think we only did like one, campaign.
Come on up, my dude. Johnny's frozen again. Johnny, what happened? Johnny's like totally frozen out here. Oh, what? Did you see it was two me's for a second there? That was wild. What's going on? Johnny.
Okay, I'm back.
He's back. Okay, there we go.
It just like keeps disconnecting. It says awaiting endpoint.
That's weird.
So then I just disconnect and then reconnect.
Well, either way, yeah, climb back up. If it happens again, I need to let you go here in like 20 minutes so we can just... watch some videos for a little while, some more of our classic videos if need be, with our lovely, lovely classic videos, which I know you are loving so much, chat.
So good.
Anyway, D&D, you played one session or one campaign?
Like one campaign.
Okay.
What was really like, I don't know, about a few months later, one of the elders came to me and was like, hey, I heard you play Dungeons and Dragons. And I was like, yeah, I was like, I just played for the first, you know, for the first time ever, you know, it was pretty cool. You know, he's like, well, he's like, if I'd have known that you played D&D, I wouldn't have hired you. And I was like, what? I like, just like blew my mind. And apparently, like, he went on to just talk about how when he was younger, he was like a rule follower, like never broke the rules, you know, like he didn't really like sin or whatever, you know, like he didn't, he didn't like party or do anything. He was like, but the way he's like, but I would sin through playing the game. Like, that's where I would like do all the things I am not allowed to do and whatever. So
interesting.
It was like, yeah, it was just, and I was like, wow. I was like, well, that's, I was like, that's crazy that you said like you wouldn't have even hire me. I'm like, I didn't even have the opportunity to ever play before I came here.
Yeah.
Like, so, so you still would have hired me because I didn't play, you know?
That's wild.
He's not an elder anymore. He's not at the church anymore. it's a, it's completely different culture now.
Yeah.
You know, me and Dan would play, Magic the Gathering, you know, with students all the time.
Yeah.
And everything. And, is, yeah,
that's a conversation I had to have with parents a lot of you play Magic with the students, like, is that okay, you know, isn't that right, evil, whatever else. And you know, it was always just a discussion. Like, the first thing I would always tell them, which, chat, you've heard this 100 times from me, is it's a game made by Hasbro, like Monopoly or Battleship or, you know, Clue. They're games made by Hasbro, and Magic the Gathering and Dungeons and Dragons are both that as well. And second of all, like any game, it's made for fun. I hope you're not like worried that you're, when your kid plays Monopoly, that they're secretly going to become a property mogul. Like,
right.
No, they're playing a game and having a good time. It's fine.
You're like, and that wouldn't be a bad thing, right? Becoming a property mogul.
Oh, we had to latch on to that. Dang it.
Yep.
We're over here just on auto mode, not paying attention.
So it has been, it's been nice, like, seeing that change, you know, happen to where it's not like this.
Oh, no. Nice. Good work, weird, you.
You know, like.
Oh, no.
I tried so hard.
Exactly. So yeah, boomer parents grew up playing Monopoly. Exactly, Wasabi Jane. And now they have been tainted with wanting to be property moguls. You can tell that the devil is in them. Through all of the Monopoly playing they have done, and that's why Monopoly is satanic. That's what
exactly.
Man, I'm glad that sort of idea is kind of going away, because it all happened with the Satanic Panic, which was back in the 70s. There was like a couple of cults of kids. I mean, it happened very much like Stranger Things, where there were cults of kids who were into really weird things. And then there was one of them who was part of an actual cult, and they went and like were studying these kids, and the kind of the only common thread they found was that they played Dungeons and Dragons. And so it was immediately this thought process, oh, Dungeons and Dragons must be satanic. Like, it must, it must be the thing that made them this way. And, it's a game. Gary Gygax was a Christian, ultra conservative type, but the ironic thing is Gary Gygax is Christian. Dang it. Let's try this again. Adventures and Odysseys, with that episode, definitely wouldn't listen to that. No, what is Adventures and Odyssey? Wasabi Jane, you have to explain this to me.
Okay, I'm going to stand here, so then you rest it against me.
Right.
And then you go, yeah.
Oh nope, nope. Get wrecked, you.
Rolled me off.
Okay, I'm going to stand a little bit closer over here.
Okay, at least, well, we're not wrapped around the thing anymore, so.
I know about, like, chick tracks and whatnot.
Here, you come push it slowly, and then I'm going to go to the left. Or you go to the left.
Yeah,
and get
okay,
ready
that's what I was doing. Yep, I got it.
No, on the other side of me.
On the other side of you, like this?
It's going to go up, and then you're going to jump up and grab
oh,
that.
Oh, all the way to like this. I see what you're saying. Yeah.
So it's gonna be kind of fast. There we go. Jump.
Oh, close. It didn't give enough oomph. I think you got to do it the quick roll, so it like flips me up.
Oh, okay. Come down
and
follow me
to the rope. Yeah. I just thought of the same thing. what was that episode though? Like, what happened? And was there a D&D episode of it? Like the Darkest Dungeon chick track? There we go. That was it. Now you got to swing, my friend. Nice. Oh, I saw that too. There was a lot of like good intention stuff out there at the time that, as we look back, realize it was more damaging than helpful. But again, mm-hmm. all the good intentions. D&D Satanic episode where a character's troubled cousin came into town and they wound up LARPing in the woods and sacrificing a doll.
Wow.
Again, it just shows like this misunderstanding of what D&D is.
Yeah. For sure.
The Darkest Dungeon chick track is about a girl like coming to a new school and being asked to play D&D. And then after a while, they're like, oh, you've done so good in D&D. Now it's time for you to learn the real magic. And then, you know, she gets into real magic and it's wild. Nope. We're going through. If people could see what D&D really is, Fubadoo, hey! We were just talking about you, man.
You got to watch the replay.
Yeah. We're just talking about what a terrible person you were for teaching Johnny how to play Dungeons and Dragons. Yeah, how dare you. Wait.
Ooh, dear eye.
Okay.
Wait.
And now... Don't kill me! He killed me.
Okay. I believe in you.
Okay. Ready? We gotta go whoop. And then, nope. No. Oh, no, I see. I think I hide right under that rock right there.
Oh, okay. And it'll just bounce over you?
I think so. I'm hoping so. You learned what D&D was because of that episode. there's some irony there.
Yay, the devil. Oh, my goodness.
Yeah. Now, I've used D&D as a ministry tool, same with Magic the Gathering, like just playing games with students. And, you know, it's a great way to have in-person community. I mean, especially today with the amount of people and the amount of times that I found out yesterday that the average American has 7 hours of screen time a day. 7 hours. Wow. That's wild. And
that's it.
I found that out because my wife and I were talking about, like, I was teasing her that she's on her phone too much. And she's like, well, how much are you on your phone? And I'm like, maybe an hour and a half a day. And 45 minutes of that is Marvel Snap. Like, and that's about it. So we were like, well, you know, what's bad? Like, what is too much? And we looked that up. And we're like, oh, never mind. We're both just fine. Comparatively, we are just fine. It is. Oh, my bad. Oh, we can swim. Oh, never mind.
Oh, I think we can.
Yeah, Wasabi Jane says she's at 7 hours. Yeah. It's a big part of why. No, I think we need to get in the log. Oh, no, there you go. You're right. It's a big part of why I started Save Point Ministries is to get people not on their cell phone for 7 hours a day and instead have them on, oh, one of them fish is going to eat us. Instead, have them introduced to physical communities that hopefully at some point you can play games. Like, games are such a good tool. I told you we talk about this eventually, Johnny. Gaming is such a good ministry tool that the church has just straight up neglected for so long. Like, inexplicably just straight up been like, no, we don't want to use that. Yeah, sure, it's a community-based thing that brings people together with love and joy, but no, it's bad. Not that. So weird.
For sure.
Oh, that's a fish.
Oh, nice. You jumped on it.
Yeah, man. I thought that was a log. That fish is coming for us, Johnny.
Oh,
I see. We're supposed to jump on it again. We got to wait there for it, and it'll come back.
All right.
Yeah.
Smart.
So take that. Oi, get back up there, me. Oi, híjole. All right. Ooh. No, it's cool. There it is. Yes.
Yeah. Oh, man. So a lot of the students in my youth right now are, and I think that this is probably a lot of places, but really into Minecraft.
Oh yeah.
And so I've created like a realm. I've got a, Okay. Yeah. Hold.
Yeah. I got it.
That up and all.
You just got to run and jump. Oh, swing. There you go. Yeah. Swing over.
Can I get that thing?
I bet you can. Watch out for the fish though. He's going to eat you. There you go. Nice.
So yeah, I've got a realm going for them and everything. It's just, it's really cool. So I've been playing a lot of Minecraft lately with the students.
Man, I got into Minecraft like literally when it first dropped. When it first, after Cave Game and it became Minecraft, I got into it with a friend and we were like, oh, nope, I got chomped. We were way into it, but you know, just after a while you get out of it. And then when my kids got old enough, I introduced them to Minecraft. And come on, I'm so sorry. The fact that like when you hit a lily pad, there's a half second where you can't jump because it's like dipping down, that keeps messing with me.
That fish is so into you.
Yeah. It is. Very good. I'm actually literally into the fish. I'm within it right now.
I am into the fish.
Nope. See, I done did it again. All right, I got it. It's fine. It's fine. Everything is fine. It's not fine. I'm so sorry. Here, wait. Take me.
Oh, dude. Okay, I got you.
Johnny, take the wheel. Take it from my hands. Because I can't do this on my own. Oh, no. Never mind. Song over. Song over.
I hesitated. I should have just went for it.
Come on, we gotta beat this. Just gotta beat this level. Okay, my turn. Get out of here. Get out of here. Right. Now that you climb on. Nope. Wrong way. Climb onto me. Here we go. We're gonna make this happen. Ready?
Yes. You are the wind beneath my wings.
There we have to come up
with a song, right? Good job.
Thank you.
Magic.
Don't want your garbage fish. Don't want your garbage fish.
That was my issue as I was. Trying to jump from the lily pads that were connected.
Ah.
So you could just run across.
Instead of just running across.
Like an extra jump, yeah.
Okay. It's all right. Right here. Hoop.
Hey, yep.
We got a boat.
Hey, yep.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. It's okay. We killed it. Oh, kick that fish. Oh, no. Dang, man. Okay. You can come back now.
You knocked it out with the oar.
Yeah. I legitimately wanted it to be dead. There was some like visceral anger in there, some vengeance that I desired. Yeah.
Again, I thought it was you. I was like, oh man, I cleared nice. That so easy. I'll do a bridge here.
Is that what we're doing, a bridge?
Maybe.
Bridge to where?
That's a good question.
I think we're pulling it.
Oh, are we? Oh, okay.
No.
Try this way.
Oh, hang on. Maybe we got to pull it together. No, okay.
There's a brick.
Yep, I see the brick.
Oh.
Ah, there we go. Yep, I see it now. Okay.
You got to fling.
Okay. We're tying. Hang on.
Oh, there we go. Yeah.
You got it?
Yep.
Okay. And now we're going to push this over here. It has Little Big Planet. Imagine if Little Big Planet was like a. Was a beautiful indie game about memory. You know, that's what this game is.
For her, sure.
I love the Little Big Planet games. They're one of the few video games that my wife would play with me regularly.
Mm-hmm.
And how do I? Oh, there we go. And we recently when the PS5 came out, Sackboy Big Adventure was our first game that we got with it. I think that's what we're supposed to do here, right? No, wait.
We somehow
Wait. Here first, and then to the stove.
Oh, yeah.
And then we're going to put it in the stove.
Oops.
Nope.
Wasn't back far enough.
Got it. I can't do it. It's too far. Like, I'm at the end of my rope.
I'm at the end of my rope.
All right. And then.
Wow. Then don't get
do
cooked.
This. And we got to do the other side.
How did we get
right
over there?
To the right. Go to the right. You go to the right. And then right there. Oh, yeah, tie off on that.
I wasn't sure if I had to, like, jump across or something.
There we go.
Sweet. I thought it was, like, going to turn the stove on somehow.
Oh, right. I should probably, there we go. I don't feel like that's enough. Why is that not enough? Oh, wait. Launch me, yo. Push that brick off.
Oh, okay.
My turn. Whee!
Very nice.
All right. What is this? Is it a dead swan?
It could be.
I think I remember this.
There he goes.
Not dead.
Oh, he's alive.
Just, yeah.
He was just sleeping. He needed two Yarnies to wake him up.
Aww.
Oh. We could have gotten to the end of the game. Just held on.
Yeah.
Oh no, 5 minutes.
It's okay. We only get an hour at a time. That's so weird. I wonder why.
Yeah, it is interesting.
Get it. Just get it. Spider-Man it.
Like, tell us where to go. The claw.
The claw.
The light. It guides us where to go.
Okay. Ooh. There it is. Aw. That was a good episode. It ended with them. We're all happy. So that's a good place for us to end as well.
For sure.
Here's what's going to happen, Johnny.
Yes.
I want you to tell us one more time about Broadway Christian Church and about, you know, what kind of stuff you guys have coming up, where they can find you and whatnot. And meanwhile, I am going to find another video of ours.
Okay, cool. So yeah, Broadway Christian Church is in East Mesa in Arizona. So if you are someone who's looking to get connected, want to be a part of people who are part of a community, then this is where you need to come. And if you are of the nerd persuasion and you are into nerdy things, you are accepted at our church, and we would love to play games with you, whatever it is. The only thing that I haven't ever gotten into was Pokemon. I was just like a little too old when it first came out. And then I don't know. I was like, it's the one thing where I'm like, oh, people who play Pokemon, those are nerds, you know, but I play Magic and I play D&D and like read comics and everything. And, so come on, check us out. We're on Instagram. The Instagram handle is
Hamble.
The YGBCC, which that just stands for the youth group. It was the easiest thing to brand. So yeah, the YG BCC. Come check us out. Get connected that way. We do have a Facebook page as well. I think the church does anyway.
Yeah. BCC Mesa, yeah.
Yes, yeah. I'm not on Facebook, so I miss out on that stuff.
I got to do all my social research before I, you know, have a guest and whatnot. So yeah, you do actually.
Yeah, yeah, for sure. And then also, if you're out of high school, you've graduated, you're looking for a place to connect. We have a group that meets on Wednesday nights, like I said, for young adults. I mean, honestly, full disclosure, I turned 40 this year, so I am 39. Right now, so you know,
I turned 40
graduated
last month
to at least 40. You know, you're welcome. and honestly, like if you're wanting to connect, you know, with people around your age who are trying to move forward in their faith, then come check us out. We like to just hang out and share food together. That's called Beyond. That's on Wednesday nights. So, yeah, come check us out. We'd love to have you.
Awesome. Johnny, thanks so much. It's been a joy to have you. Let's watch one more video real quick, huh?
I'm excited.
Let's watch one more. What do we have?
Oh, the stomp video. Oh, man. That haircut. I don't know what I was thinking. That's what I have in the Sanjaya's 10,000 Water Balloon Bonanza videos.
That's right, man.
We'll make those viewable once we're done here. All those haircuts. Oh, you know what? We did a Harry Potter video. Remember?
No.
It was just a random video. We're like, we're witches. And you're like, well, wizards. And we're just like saying random Harry Potter references.
Really? Oh my gosh. Yeah, I know all of these haircuts, Dan. Dan, by the way, Fubadoo was also an intern here at this time, but he was an intern with the children's ministry, where we were with the youth ministry. Kind of a groove.
It's like I said, like, I felt like it was a lot better when we were doing it.
Definitely sometimes, like, there's, you're clearly not playing with a metronome, are you guys?
Right.
There was a point where we all just stopped. This was not scripted, by the way. The whole part of the video was, hey, let's do some stomp stuff. Like, just get some stuff and we'll play a beat. That was it. I remember thinking to myself, how are we gonna stop this? Like, we didn't discuss when we stop it.
I think I just improvised. I was like,
the whole time. I said,
that was the best.
Yeah, Jeremiah and the other guy. I don't remember the other guy's name. Darren, Jeremiah and Darren. Oh, man. That was good times.
He's still doing ministry in Indiana. And so if you're in Indiana area, I don't remember what his church name is, but let me. Leave a comment on one of my YouTube videos.
Yeah, there you go. If you're here. Oh, man. Well, Johnny, thank you again so much for being here. One more time, guys. That's Broadway Christian Church in Mesa, Arizona. If you're in the Mesa area, go check out Broadway. Sunday, Wednesday, they got all kinds of stuff going on. It has been wonderful. We love that each and every one of you guys have been here. But always remember that there's a church out there that would love it if you were there. Mm-hmm. Have a good one, guys. We'll see you later. Thank you.